Dusty Tomes Audiobooks and Spoken Realms present The American Nation, A History in 27 Volumes, Volume 6, Provincial America, 1690-1740, by Evarts Boutell Greene, narrated by Joseph Tabler. Editor's Introduction. To the period between 1689 and 1740 has been applied the term the forgotten half-century. Most of the writers on colonial history in detail give special attention to the 17th century, the period of upbuilding, and the general historians like Bancroft and Hildreth sweep rather lightly over the epoch between the English Revolution and the forerunnings of the American Revolution. In distributing the parts of the American nation, this period has been selected for a special treatment because within it are to be found the roots of many later institutions and experiences. The external side of provincial history, especially in relations with France, has been reserved for Thwaites' France in America, Volume 7 of this series, except so far as it affected the internal development of the colonies previous to 1713. Space is thus available for a constitutional treatment which shall bring out the general imperial system of Great Britain, the organs and methods of colonial control, and the principles of domestic government in America, and to put the subject in a proper relation with the economic and social life of the time. The book begins with an account of imperial conditions in 1689, Chapter 1. The next four chapters are devoted to various phases of colonial government and bring into relief the disposition of the English authorities to tighten the reins of colonial control, the establishment of the English church in some of the colonies, and the attempt to bring the colonies into the English system, ecclesiastically as well as politically, is the theme of Chapter 6. Chapters 7 to 10 summarize the military struggle in the colonies brought on by the world rivalry between France and England. But this war was treated in its relations with American colonial history, leaving out the extensions of Canada and Louisiana beyond the reach of the colonists, and also avoiding the European side of the story. Chapters 11 to 13 develop the changes in imperial and local government during the first third of the 18th century, and also deal with the important subject of the beginnings of political organization in America. Chapters 14 to 18 are devoted to the social and economic development of the continental colonies, including the movement of new masses and new race elements across the ocean, the filling in of the settled area, and the pushing backward to the mountains and southward to the southern boundary of the new colony of Georgia. Special stress is laid upon the extension of the Navigation Acts to the West India and to oversea trade, thus supplementing the treatment of that subject in Andrew's Colonial Self-Government, Volume 5, Chapter 1. Within the last chapter of text, the author deals with the intellectual and literary life of the people. The critical essay on authorities ranges in order the most valuable part of the confusing literature of the period. The service of the book to the series is to build a bridge between the founding of the colonies, described in the fourth and fifth volumes of The American Nation, and the separation of the colonies, which is the subject of Howard's Preliminaries of the Revolution, Volume 8. Its theme is the essential difficulty in reconciling imperial control with the degree of local responsibility which had to be accorded to the colonists. Author's Preface. The half-century of American history which follows the English Revolution of 1689 presents peculiar difficulties of treatment. The historian must deal with the experience of 13 different colonies, which were, however, ultimately to become one nation, and which even then possessed important elements of unity. Within the limits of a single volume, it is obviously impossible to tell the story of each individual colony, and at the same time to discuss the general movements of the time. It is the author's conviction that the most instructive method for the student of this period is to emphasize the general movements. The history of this provincial era is comparatively deficient in dramatic incidents, and the interest lies rather in the aggregate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.